guys, Glenn here. I'm working on my custom artist presets for the Helix, and this first one I chose to do was a David Gilmour sound. Now, previously in the pods and boss units, you had to have like four or five separate patches to cover all of the Pink Floyd songs that I wanted to cover. But the great thing about the Helix is you can have all of those sounds within one patch. So it's like having four or five patches within a patch. And I thought it would be cool to show everybody, if you're into programming, which of course I am, if you really want to learn everything about the Helix and all the programming that's available to you, I thought it would be cool to show everybody everything that's involved in this patch. So I'm going to go each block at a time. You can create it. You can follow along with the video and create this patch and set all of your settings. Now, I kind of go over this stuff pretty quick, and there's a lot to it. But if you have to pause the video, just pause it and you can see the settings more clearly. Okay? So I'm going to play along with this backing track to Shine On You Crazy Diamond. I created the backing track myself and I tried to get as close to the original recording that I could. So I'm going to demonstrate the sound on sound feature in the recording. I'm going to engage it right before the full band comes in, so you'll be able to hopefully hear that. For the guitar, I'm going to be using a James Tyler Variax, the JTV69, but I'm not using the Line 6 guitar models. I'm using the pickups on the guitar, which are very good, by the way. They're a James Tyler pickups, and I love the way they sound, and it's perfect for this style of music, for a David Gilmour tone. And so just want to let you know, I'm not using the Line 6 models. You're going to want to use a Strat, though, to get as close to the tone as possible. So anyway, here goes, on with the music. Thank you. okay, so just to show you how I have this patch and all of the pedals laid out, here I have a drive, tremolo, chorus, delay, a lead boost, and this is the amp gain, which actually switches between the two amps. I have a univibe, a phaser. This is more reverb. When the switch is off, you have just a little reverb, but when you engage this switch, it adds a lot of reverb. And this is the sound on sound switch. Now, you can see it turns on these two delays right here, but this one here is the one that gives a sound on sound. Now, I want you to check this out, how I have the pedal. You see this feedback knob here? See that? It's connected to the pedal. So to use the sound on sound, and I'm going to demonstrate this, you have the pedal in the heel position, you click it on, you do your swell, and as you're doing your swell with the cord, you bring up the pedal. Then you turn off the sound on sound, and what that's going to do is it's going to just keep repeating that swell over and over. And to stop it, you have to turn it back on and move the pedal to the heel position, and that'll turn it off. See that? So that's how that works. So that's how I have all the switches and everything laid out. And now I'm going to show you each block and all of its parameters. Okay, very first thing in the chain, volume. Volume pedal, you just add that, it's automatically connected to the pedal, okay? Very next thing in the chain is I use the Vetta Wah, okay? And that's connected to the toe expression pedal. It's automatically connected. Now, I want you to notice this. You see this mix parameter? I have it set at 42. I find that on the Wah, if it's at 100, and all of the other Line 6 pods were like this, by the way, I found that if it was set at 100%, the Wah just really takes over your sound completely. It doesn't sound right. So I have mine set at 42. Everything else is, I think these may be the default settings. Okay, next in the chain is the Deluxe Comp. Now here are my settings. Minus 50 dB on the threshold, 4:1 ratio, 200 millisecond attack, I have that all the way up. 130 millisecond release time, 100% of the mix, and the level is at 9 dB, and the knee is at plus 19 dB. Okay. Next is the tremolo, and that's activated by the tremolo switch on the pedal board. And these are the settings. Okay, now we're going to drop down to this next path here. Now, to do that, all you got to do is move the joysticks down, and it'll open up that path. Now, this here is the Univibe. That's turned on by the Univibe switch, and these are all the settings: rate 5.5, intensity 1.4. It's in chorus mode. Lamp bias at 5.4, 50% mix, and 0 dB on the level. Next is the phaser. It's the script mod phase, and these are the settings. 1.0 on the rate, 49% on the mix, and 3.5 on the dB. Now we're going to go up, and all of these, you'll notice all of these are before this amp. Okay, this amp here. All of these blocks are hitting the front of this amp. This parameter here is a 10-band graphic EQ, but you'll notice the settings. I'm using it, all of these are all set at zero. I'm using it as kind of a treble booster. Okay, the 1 kHz is set at 2.8, but if you go to the second page, you'll see 2 kHz is at plus 4, 4 kHz is at plus 4, and 8 kHz is at plus 4, and the level is at 4.5. Now what that does, it adds more sustain to the amp, and it gives it a little more of a brighter sound, and it gives your notes more attack. Okay, now we're gonna look at this amp. This is a Marshall Brit 2204. I have the drive at 1.0, the bias at 5.4, the mids at 5, treble at 6.7, presence at 7.7, the channel volume is at 9. The master volume is at 6. Now, this controller here is tied to foot switch 5, which is the lead boost. So, in the minimum value, the master is at 6. But when you hit the lead boost, it'll jump up to 7. Now watch, I'm going to hit the lead boost button. See that? Okay. Lead boost also ties, the lead boost also turns on a couple of other things, which I'm going to show you once I get down here. Okay, next. Oh, in the next screen here, you see I have my sag at 6.7. The hum is at 5. That's default. Ripple is at 5. That's also default. I have the bias turned up to 8.2 and the bias excursion turned up to 7.9. Now, I'm using the 412 1960 T75 cab. I'm using a 57 mic, dynamic mic. The distance is at about 3 inches. Low cuts off, high cuts off. Early reflection is at 0 and the level is at 0. So that's that amp. Now, right after the amp, I have a delay block. It's a delay mod chorus and it's tied to the sound on sound button. Now this delay does not create the sound on sound delay. I just have it on here to beef up the sound. And you notice I'm using the mod chorus echo. Now these are the settings I have: 538 on the time, 28 on the feedback, 155 hertz on the low cut, 9.5 kilohertz on the high cut. The mix is at 45, and we'll go to the next page. Scale is at 100%. I have it in chorus mode. Speed at 0.2. Depth almost all the way up. Turn that up to 100 if you want. And the spread is at 9.9. And the delay trails are off. Those actually, that should be on. Okay. Now, let's go down to the next bottom path. Very first thing is another amp. And of course, David Gilmour was famous for using high watt amps, so this is the Whowatt 100. Now, here are all the settings for that. Drive at 5. Oh. I almost forgot. Sorry. Right before the amp, also, I have a drive pedal that's tied to the drive button. It's the compulsive drive. These are my settings. Gain at 6.6, tone at 10, peak at low type, version, it's set at version 2. Version 4 I find is much of a darker tone, which I don't like that much, so. And the level is at 6.5. So that's this the drive pedal. Now let's go down to the bottom row. Now this is, like I was saying, this is the Whowatt 100. These are my settings. 5.0 on the drive, bass is set at 9, mids at 4.9, treble at 4.7, presence at 4.2, channel volume is at 6. We'll go to the next screen. Master at 6.6, sag at 7.7, the hum is down to 3.2, ripple at 5, again that's 5 is the default setting for I think all of these. Bias at 5.3, bias excursion at 5.9. Now, on this cab, we're using the default cab that comes with that amp. It's set on a 421 dynamic mic. The distance is at 1 inch, which is right up on the cone. The more you move this back, the less full the sound, the less full your tone will. How can I say this? To get the fullest tone, you keep this at 1, which is right on the speaker. The further you pull this back, the tone will suffer. It's going to become much brighter and less full. Low cut is off, high cut is off, early reflection at 0, level at 0. Now, this amp Marshall are tied to the switch. With the amp gain switch off, you're using the Who Watt. When I switch the amp gain, it switches to the Marshall. That's the cool thing about all this DSP power. Within this one patch, you can have basic, you can cover a whole Pink Floyd set. Okay. On the other pods, I had to have four or five different patches to cover all of this stuff. But now you can do it all within this one patch. So there, this amp gain switch will switch between the two. Now the Marshall amp adds a little bit more gain, but not much. To get, if you want to get distortion, you engage the drive pedal. Okay, now we're gonna drop down here. Now this is the lead boost parameters here. Now as I showed you earlier, along with turning the master volume up on that Marshall amp, it's also gonna turn on a simple EQ. So go ahead and add a simple EQ to that this path down here, and almost all of them are set at default. The mid frequency is at 600 Hertz, but the level, this is the important thing. This will give you your volume boost. I have it set at plus 4.1, 4, whatever, anywhere around there. If you need more volume to cut through the mix, you raise that up. Okay, I have it set at 4. For recording purposes, this is about the right level, but if you're playing live, you're gonna wanna have this on at least 5 or 5.5. That's what I've found, okay. Now, along with the lead boost, have a ping pong delay. Turns both of those on. Mixes at 35, the time is at 400 milliseconds, 20% on the feedback, scale at 50%, spread at 10, 35 on the mix, 0 level, 0 dB on the level. Now I have a low and a high cut on these, and trails should be on again on this. Low cut at 100 Hertz and 8.9 on the high cut. Okay, now, also in this bottom path here, I have a simple delay. Now, this delay is set for some of the songs on the Wall album, okay? You can use this delay to get that effect. Now here are the settings on that. 375 on the time, the milliseconds, 80% on the feedback, 50% on the mix, plus 4 dB on the level, scale at 100%, and trails are on, okay? Now we're gonna bump up, we're almost finished now with this whole patch. Last thing is the reverb. Now as I explained earlier, I have two parameters that are tied to foot switch 10, okay? And when you press foot switch 10 at the minimum settings with the foot switch off, the reverb is still on, but the decay is at 1.4. By the way, I'm using a spring reverb here. With the reverb switch, more reverb switch off, the decay is at 1.4, pre-delay is at 0, low cut of 260, high cut of 4.3 Hertz. The mix is at 30%. On the second page, reverb trails, those should be on. Now, this mix knob here is also tied to the more reverb. And you see it's at set at 30%. This is the minimum value with the switch off. When I press the switch, it's gonna bring it up to 50%, and the decay is gonna jump up to 4%. That's gonna give you a really nice long-lasting reverb effect on this sound. And you'll be able to hear that at the very end of the song where I cut almost all of the effects off. You can hear it's just almost a dry sound, okay? To apply these parameters to switch, all you do is you press and hold the knob you want to assign to a switch, and then with this controller I have it set on controller foot switch 10. And it's at the mix parameter, which is, this will be, whenever you press, whatever knob you press on, it'll be, this will, the parameter will be set to that knob. Minimum value is at 30%, maximum value is at 50%. And you can see these change. Okay. And then we have a chorus. I'm using the Trinity chorus. The rate is set at 3.8. Depth, left depth at 7.8. Center depth at 8.5. Right depth at 7.2. LFO, PRST, I'm not sure what that stands for. LFO manual, I would say. Those are both on. Left boost off, center boost off, right boost off. It's in stereo mode. The mix is at 38%. Level is at 0 dB. So that's the whole patch. Now you can lay your board out as I showed earlier, but you can rearrange these switches. You can put them anywhere you want.